dollars for, to pay me back for socking you?
Forget the other night. Our personal brawls haven't anything to do with the fight game.
I thought you wanted to hold out till next year.
Yeah, till I found out how much McGraw's been drinking. He can't get back in good shape in 4 weeks. And with this feud appearing in the papers, why, that's good for $1 million gate.
I had an idea. You wanted to get rid of me.
Say, if I didn't want to take the title away from those guys, I'd have shoved you overboard for going against orders and knocking out O'Brien. Ask Silver. He talked me out of it.
That's right, Nick. Why'd you tell the newspapers you're going to send the kid in slugging?
Because that's what he's going to do. McGraw's ripe for it. Now, you can punch harder than he can. You're in perfect shape, and you can take it. The sooner you wash him up, the less punishment he's going to take. If you get on that bicycle for 12 rounds, you're going to give him all sorts of chances to land a lucky punch.
I don't like to argue with
you're
you.
You're not going to, or else I get another trainer. And I don't want any sparring partners. I want punchers. And I want you to send him in punching all the time. And him, too. Now, listen, kid. I never did you wrong yet, did I?
No, you haven't, Nick.
Well, then listen to me, no matter what anyone else tells you. McGraw asked for a shellacking when he pushed you around the club, and you said you'd pay him back for it, didn't you?
Yes.
Okay. We sign this afternoon. We meet at the commissioner's office at 2 o'clock. All right.
So long, Nick.